Well, our island hopping series continues, and it takes us to the Big Island this morning. And joining us this morning is Hawaii County Mayor himself, Billy Kinoy. Good morning, Mayor. How are you doing?
Hey, good morning, man.
Good to see you.
Thank you.
You know, let's first talk about, you know, when you look at the census from 2010, there was a 24.5% increase in the population growth on the Big Island, one of the largest for all the islands. What do you attribute the population growth on the Big Island to?
Well, I think it's a couple of things. One, of course, because we're residents of Hawaii Island. I mean, we're proud at the beauty of Hawaii Island, the quality of life, but also because of affordability. You know, we saw during the last decade an incredible boom in the real estate prices throughout the state of Hawaii, and Hawaii Island is one of those last places that working families in Hawaii can be able to own and purchase a home.
You know, talking a little bit about that and families and the quality of life on the Big Island, let's talk a little bit about the economy, because when you look at all four counties throughout the state, everyone has kind of suffered through this downturn of the economy, and Big Island is not immune to that. How would you describe the state of the Big Island economy right now and where you guys are at?
Well, I think we, like other municipalities across the country, we're part of this global, national, local recession. So we were hard hit in our main employment sectors, construction, hospitality. Through these last few years, in spite of the challenging economic times, we held on. Our hospitality industry has rebounded. Agriculture has remained a base of our economy. We see the retail, hotel sectors coming back. Construction is still much slower than we'd wish it was. But people are starting to become cautiously optimistic that we're starting to see more activity in the construction sector. So it's been tough, it's been challenging, but I think Hawaii Island is perfectly positioned to take advantage of the economic recovery we know will come.
You know, you touched upon agriculture briefly just a minute ago, and agriculture continues to be one of the mainstays for the Big Island, of course, with all the ag lands and all the things that you guys produce. But there's also, we've done reports on the invasive species that are currently only specifically found on the Big Island, koki frogs, the fire ants, and the things that are affecting the Kona coffee now. You know, what steps are you folks doing to secure the agriculture community on the Big Island?
Well, our response to invasive species, which threaten our unique and fragile ecosystem and environment, is to take a collaborative approach. We know we have to work with United States Department of Agriculture, State Department of Ag, with our community stakeholders, and of course the county plays a facilitative and supportive role in that. But we know solutions are found through cooperation and collaboration and collective effort, not through finger-pointing, excuses, or blame. So sometimes I do think, like, wow, Hawaii Island, again. But people respond really well on Hawaii Island. Everybody, you know, it's a big island, but a very small community.
You know, there's a lot of exciting things coming to the Big Island. I mean, you look at the development of the astronomy department and as well as the expansion of the university system. Highlight some of those things for us about what are some of the projects that are coming to the Big Island.
Well, of course, we have a $1.2 billion 30-meter telescope that is being planned for the top of Mauna Kea, which is entirely appropriate as Mauna Kea is a sacred mountain and astronomy to Native Hawaiians is a sacred science. But we see University of Hawaii at Hilo becoming a center of academic excellence in the Pacific. We just graduated our first class, the UH College of Pharmacy, which became immediately accredited thanks to Dean John Pizzuto, his leadership there. We lead the state in renewable energy around geothermal, solar, wind, ocean thermal energy conversion. As we see greater instability in the Middle East and around fossil fuel and oil prices, Hawaii Island is leading and showing the rest of the state how best take advantage of our natural assets and resources.
Well, some very exciting things coming up for the Big Island, and Mayor Kinoy will be back here a little bit later in our broadcast to share some of the products that make the Big Island so unique and the island that we both love to be, we represent all the time. And if you want to see this interview again, you can head over to the top video section of our website at kitv.com. And again, tune in tomorrow as Island Hopping continues as we go to the island of Lanai. We'll talk to the chair of the Lanai Chamber of Commerce about how Lanai really is and how they feel about having a wind farm being put in their neighborhood, plus getting around at record high gas prices. All that tomorrow on Island Hopping. But again, Mayor Kinoy will be back in just a bit to share some of the products. You're watching KITV 4 News this morning. It is 6:17.